holy diver. You've been down too long in the midnight sea. Oh, what's becoming of me?
I'm Shredmaster Scott, and this video is called How Would Bach Play Dio? We'll take the horned inventor's classic Holy Diver and reinterpret it using Bach's prime, inversion, retrograde, and retrograde inversion. Counterpoint is the interaction between two or more musical voices. Bach's fugues and inventions demonstrate this masterful craft in action. We'll be using Bach's prime, inversion, retrograde, and retrograde inversion to see how we might have interpreted Dio's Holy Diver. The question is, will Dio ride the tiger to victory, or will the Lord of Baroque banish our horned hero into the midnight sea? All right, here we go. Bach versus Dio. Let's check it out. First up, we're in the key of C minor containing three flats. And here is the prime, or the original version. Key of C minor is cool because we don't usually get to use it in metal. That's usually some jazz bullshit. Next up is the inversion, or the intervals of the prime upside down. Boxside down, if you will. What that means is anytime the prime goes up, the inversion goes down. Anytime the prime goes down, the inversion is going to go up. It's a mirror image. Turned out pretty cool, actually. Ride a tiger. You can see his stripes, but you know he's clean. Now the retrograde is the prime backwards. Everyone knows this as Bachwards. So if you come to the end of the retrograde and go from right to left, you see this is just the original riff. Great way to release the demons in your life. The retrograde inversion is the intervals of the retrograde flipped or upside down. So anytime the retrograde goes up, the retrograde inversion is going to be going down, and vice versa. Now check this out, I've got a three-voice counterpoint using fingerstyle technique. And this is more like in the style of Bach. Lots of diminished chords. The end part is kind of cool here with some contrary motion between the two outer voices, ending on a Lydian cluster. If this stuff seems too complicated and over your head, don't worry about it. Just ride the tiger a few times, you'll be fine. Ride the tiger. You can see his stripes, but you know he's clean. Oh, don't you see what I mean? I've composed a short solo using the Bach variations. This is a practical way to apply the concepts in a songwriting scenario. Let's be honest, now you're way cooler than the other shredders. Now it's your turn. Make a piece of music using these Bach variations. You can grab the tab and backing track in the description below. Upload the finished product to Instagram and tag Shredmaster Scott. I'll post my favorite submissions in my stories. Until next time, shred till you're dead.